WMC, the news center of the Mid-South, here is Action News 5.
Good evening. I'm Janet Morris. Jarvis Greer will have sports later in this broadcast. A tremendous amount of rain has fallen in a very short time here in the Mid-South. Memphis Light, Gas, and Water reports that power is out in an estimated 5,000 homes from Millington to East Memphis, downtown to Whitehaven. Virtually every area is reporting power failure and flooding. The fire department has fielded dozens of reports of motorists trapped in cars by flash flooding and in houses and apartments. The glow from the setting sun was barely visible when lightning started to move across the skies over downtown. Minutes later, rain was everywhere. Streets around the Memphis area flooded quickly. Here you see a driver on East Parkway at Union who didn't see the danger until too late. His car started floating in deep water. Bystanders and police managed to push the floating car to safety with the driver still inside. This scene was repeated over and over in Midtown tonight and in other areas of the city. We have Dick Williams here now to tell us about what the outlook is.
Oh, 24 years of reporting the weather here, and I don't remember a night like tonight. Over 4 inches of rain in 2 hours, and something about flash flooding. More people are damaged or hurt by running their car into deep water than anything else in flash flooding. So don't drive in deep water. It only takes about 2 or 3 feet of water to float a car and float you away. Incidentally, a flash flood warning is out for Shelby County until 10:30 tonight. Storm Surge 5 on the 144-mile range shows that most of the severe thunderstorms have moved east of Memphis and down into North Mississippi, but still a large area of rain. This rain is generally moving to the east at about 10 miles an hour, very slowly, and dumping a lot of rain. We'll be checking those rainfall amount reports a little bit later on in this newscast with our Weather Watchers report. I think you'll be surprised at some of the amounts.
On his last night at work, Dick has undoubtedly been the busiest man in the building.
I can't remember being this busy in the 24 years that I've been here reporting the weather. It was busy tonight. Let's take a look and see how busy our weather watchers were. Not much to report. Look at all those zeros reporting. Nothing in the rain gauges over there. This is what was around the area. Now, this was up till about, well, no later than 9 o'clock tonight because we had to get the reports in so we can take a look at them. Now we come into Memphis itself and Shelby County. Frazier reports 2 inches of rain, but look here at Midtown at TV5, 4.35, 4 1/3 inches of rain in just a little over 2 hours. I cannot remember my 24 years of reporting weather here at TV5 ever getting that much rain in that short a time, over 4 inches of rain in about 2 hours' time. Boy, no wonder we had some flash flooding. But look at some other areas, Bartlett 10 hundredths, Ellendale 30 hundredths. I was just talking to some other folks. They had not much out there in northeastern part of the county. Once again, though, this was up and before 9 o'clock tonight, so we had to get the reports in to get them on the air. Our high today was 93 degrees, the normal high 92, the record high 104 in 1986. Our low today was 73 degrees. That was tonight. The record 61 in 1965. Mississippi River 4.7, down 0.4 feet since yesterday. Under cloudy skies with thunderstorms in the area, the temperature is 74, south the winds at 16, the barometer 30 inches even falling, the relative humidity 93%. Where's the rain now? Well, here's the Super Radar satellite picture showing a lot of thunderstorms over the central part of the country and on down into the southeast part of the country where we are tonight. Intense heat today, coupled with an upper-level low moving our way, combined to bring some big thunderstorm activity. A warm front moving to the northeast kept things unstable in our part of the country. Speaking of our part of the country, let's go in for a close-up look and see what's going on. You can see that when this was taken just a little over an hour ago, there were still quite a number of thunderstorms over in Arkansas and over the area. Storm Surge 5 on the 144-mile range shows the heaviest activity has now moved down into North Mississippi. There's still some rain, though, over the area. We'll come in the closest area right now. This is Memphis and vicinity. The blue represents the lightest rain. You can see also some green, but once again, the heaviest rain has moved down south into Mississippi, and even the west part of Memphis is starting to become dry. And we need that after over 4 inches of rain here in the central part of the city tonight. The forecast for Memphis and vicinity for tonight calls for heavy rain and urban flooding possible with thunderstorms. They should be ending by midnight tonight. A low of 70 degrees, southwesterly winds at 8 miles an hour. For tomorrow, partly cloudy, hot, and humid with scattered thunderstorms again likely, but nothing like today. High of 94 degrees, southwesterly winds at 8 miles an hour. The five-day outlook, typical summer pattern, partly cloudy skies, scattered thunderstorms, highs in the 90s, lows in the 70s. There's a new tropical depression in the central Gulf of Mexico tonight, 375 miles southeast of Galveston, Texas, gusts to 35 miles an hour, moving to the north-northwest towards Louisiana and Texas. We'll keep an eye on it.
All right.
Well, I'm not going to keep an eye on it.
Dick is trying to retire too early. We're not going to let him go just yet, so you stay with us. Tonight, we say goodbye to Dick Williams. This is Dick's final newscast. He's retiring as of tonight's newscast after 24 years here at TV5. Weatherman announcer Dick Williams wore lots of hats on TV5, but this was his favorite.
Welcome to Magic Land, a land of fantasy, fun, magic, and cartoons, all in color. Now, here's your guide for today's swinging trip through Magic Land, Mr. Magic himself, Dick Williams. Hi, are you ready for fun?
Dick brought Magic Land to Memphis in 1966. This January, Magic Land said goodbye as the longest-running magic show on American TV. Dick Williams' wife and assistant, Virginia, says those 23 years were busy ones.
We needed goldfish or bunnies or just whatever. I had to many times call and go for those. And then we had to get the clothes together. We had to write patter for everything. You see, we did 52 different shows a year.
More than 1,200 shows in all, and Dick hosted every one of them. Magic Land was truly magic for WMC-TV.
We had some 50 children in here every week. They came with their parents, and they had grandparents and friends. And if you add all of that up over the years, you touched a lot of people. And we feel like all of those people, or most of them, became our friends and watched us not only on the show on which their children appeared, but succeeding weeks after that.
TV5 General Manager Ron Clayman says Dick Williams' Magic Land was a Mid-South tradition.
He entertained generations of Mid-Southerners. There were people who came to see his show whose parents brought them, and they were now bringing their own children. So that's kind of an unusual tradition for a local television station.
Dave Brown will miss Dick Williams.
Dick Williams is one of the two people that I used as kind of a model when I was learning how to do weather. So he's largely responsible for me being a weathercaster today, I suppose, in the way that I do it. It's going to be tough not having Dick to fill in. It's always been real nice that when I'm on vacation and somebody says on the street, hey, who's taking care of the weather? I can say, don't worry, Dick's got you covered.
Getting in hardcover may be Mr. Magic's next trick. Mrs. Williams says he'll probably spend his retirement studying books on magic and perhaps writing one of his own about the Magic Land years.
He has a fine library, reads constantly. We just got two new magic books, and there are two more on the way, and you can see what we already have. But he'll never lose interest in magic, and we have made friends all over the world because of magic. It's a lot of magic in our lives.
Like so many of the people here in the Mid-South, I grew up over in Arkansas watching Magic Land, watching Dick. Jarvis got to be on Magic Land.
I also got a chance to be on Magic Land. You know, my next-door neighbor won the rabbit, so I still have to talk to you about that.
No.
But I think I was about 9 years old then, and I had a lot of fun, and I remember getting up on Saturday, Sunday mornings and watching it, and it just was a great show, and it's been great working with you.
Well, it's been great working with you folks, too. It really has, and I appreciate all you folks out there, too, that have watched over the years. The magic and the weather have been my two loves here at the station, and I especially have enjoyed working with you folks on the weekend. Bob McLean is very, very good. He can do about everything I can do, but he can't do this, and I'm working with him on this. And if Bob McLean can learn this, then he'll have a complete weathercast for you coming up starting next week.
If he can't learn it, does that mean you'll stay?
Well, I'll think about it.
Dick, we've enjoyed working with you.
Thank you.
Definitely.
Thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good week.